Flight 431, Chicago to Los Angeles. Ordinary people, ordinary trip, families going on vacation, businessmen in suits, tired eyes, a young couple holding hands, excited. The usual pre-flight rituals, safety demonstrations, seat backs upright, the familiar roar of the engines. Then we're off, soaring above the clouds. Smooth sailing, coffee is served, magazines are read, laughter is heard. Suddenly a jolt, the plane shudders. Coffee spills, people gasp, silence falls. The seatbelt sign, a beacon of warning, lights up. The plane dips again, this time more violently. Panic starts to rise, a silent wave through the cabin. What was routine is now terrifying. The unknown stretches before us, mirroring the darkening sky outside. We hit an air pocket, the plane drops, screams erupt, oxygen masks dangle, a macabre party favor no one asked for. A child cries, a woman sobs, a man closes his eyes, clutching his wife's hand. The air crackles with fear. The smell of jet fuel and sweat hangs heavy. The turbulence worsens. We are trapped in a metal tube, tossed around by unseen forces. Each bump, a hammer blow to our collective chest. The minutes stretch into an eternity. We are no longer strangers. We are united by terror, adrift in a sea of uncertainty. Our shared humanity, laid bare at 30,000 feet. A businessman, his face pale, comforts a young boy, wiping away his tears. A woman, her voice trembling, shares her oxygen mask with an elderly man. Strangers become allies, their fear giving way to compassion. Small acts of kindness bloom in the face of shared vulnerability. The flight attendants, beacons of calm in the storm, move through the aisle.
Remain calm, we're going to be all right.
Their voices, trained to soothe, offer reassurance. Their words, a lifeline in the chaos. We cling to their confidence, desperate for it to be true. The pilot's voice, steady and firm, crackles over the intercom. He acknowledges the turbulence, explains the situation. His words, measured and clear, cut through the panic. He's in control, he assures us. We are not alone. His voice becomes our anchor. He is our captain, our leader, our hope in this moment of crisis. We listen intently, hanging on to his every word. His composure, a beacon in the storm. He is the voice of reason, the voice of experience, the voice of survival. He speaks of air currents, of weather patterns, of the plane's ability to withstand the turbulence. He explains the procedures, the precautions being taken. Captain Anderson, it's going to be rough, but we will get through this. His words are technical, yet understandable. He doesn't sugarcoat it, and we believe him. Because in his voice, we hear not just a pilot, but a human being. A human being who understands fear, who acknowledges the gravity of the situation. He is not above us, dictating from a position of authority. He's with us, facing the storm head on. We are still scared, yes, but we are no longer alone. We have each other, we have the crew, and we have the captain, our steadfast guide through the turbulence. His voice, a thread of strength, weaving us together. The turbulence continues, but the atmosphere in the cabin shifts. Fear gives way to a quiet determination. We are all in this together. We will face this challenge as one. Slowly, gradually, the turbulence begins to subside. The bumps become less violent, less frequent. A collective sigh of relief sweeps through the cabin. We made it. We survived. The landing gear deploys. The familiar thud as the wheels kiss the tarmac. Applause erupts, spontaneous and heartfelt. We are on the ground. We are safe. As we disembark, there are hugs and handshakes. Strangers who shared a harrowing experience, now connected by an invisible thread. We exchange numbers, promising to stay in touch. We look at each other, really look at each other, with newfound respect and empathy. We walk into the terminal, forever changed by the experience. We are survivors, bonded by our shared humanity. The world outside seems brighter, the air sweeter. We have been tested and we have emerged stronger, more grateful, more connected. Flight 431, scheduled to be just another trip, became a testament to the human spirit. It showed us the fragility of life, the power of fear, and the importance of human connection. It reminded us that we are not alone in this world, even at 30,000 feet, that even in the face of fear, compassion can bloom, that strangers can become friends, united by shared experience. As I watch the plane taxi away, I think of the people on board. They will carry this experience with them, a reminder of their own resilience and the kindness of strangers. And they will step out into the world, a little more grateful, a little more compassionate, a little more human, because they have looked fear in the eye, and they have emerged stronger together.